This study was the first evidence of the adverse effects of COVID-19 pandemic on physical activity of Thai populations for the government and the policymakers, not only for Thailand, but also for other countries. Diana Natalia Widyastari. I'm a faculty member at the Institute for Population and Social Research, Mahidol University, and also the head of Academic Network and Development, Thailand Physical Activity Knowledge Development Center. On behalf of the author teams, it is my great honor to talk about one of our research on how COVID-19 pandemic has affected physical activity of Thai population. The article was published in the Journal of Sport and Health Science, a top 5 journal in the field of sport, exercise, physical activity, and health science, with site score 8.3. And this study was done in a collaboration between Thailand Physical Activity Knowledge Development Center, Institute for Population and Social Research, and Thai Health Promotion Foundation. So why we did this study? Because physical inactivity has been responsible for global burden of disease, which can be averted if appropriate measures are taken since the early years of life. However, let's recall 2 years ago, when the COVID-19 was firstly emerged, and shortly after, the WHO announced a pandemic state. Our reaction was probably fear, panic, or afraid. People were afraid of going out for exercise, and for some who have the urge for exercise, with public facilities being shut down, they lost the physical activity opportunities. Therefore, this research aims to compare the physical activity level before and during the COVID-19 pandemic. We also documented the change in the types and amount of physical activity from different group of population based on the socio-demographic characteristics. And as a social researchers, we have conducted our surveillance on physical activity annually since 2012. We collected the data by face-to-face interview in all regions across the country. But with the travel restrictions, it was impossible for us to collect the data in the field. We finally had to adjust our research design from face-to-face to online data collections, but by keeping the research design sound to ensure national representativeness and comparability with the previous round. This study was the first evidence of the adverse effects of COVID-19 pandemic on physical activity of Thai populations. We found that the prevalence of sufficient moderate to vigorous physical activity of Thai populations dropped from 74.3% in 2019 to 54.6% in 2020. And the prevalence of sufficient MPPA was at its lowest during the maximum curfew period, when the Thai government imposed strict restrictions to contain the virus by closing public facilities, including public parks and gyms, by prohibiting late-night travel as well. And although several measures were relaxed during the shorter curfew period and had few facility opening, the prevalence of sample with sufficient physical activity remained low, with only slight increase when the curfew was lifted. Being published in a high-impact journal, our paper has gained a lot of citations. With a strong research design during uncertain situations, we gained the momentum as we were able to collect national representative data where many researchers were enabled at the time and compare the physical activity before and during the pandemic. The result of our study also served as the solid information for the government and the policymakers, not only for Thailand, but also for other countries, providing evidence that the pandemic measures imposed by the government have reduced physical activity opportunities of the populations. We also show that although the health promotion message probably contributed to slight increase in the physical activity level, it will take some time for the individuals to return to pre-COVID levels of physical activity. Therefore, health promotion message needs to be continuously delivered in order to reduce irrational fear of infections and also to boost physical activity level of the populations. Feel free to download the full paper by following the QR code presented in this video. Thank you very much.